Central Finance can be used in conjunction with SAP Landscape Transformation Replication Server, as I told you, SLD Replication Server, and SAP Master Data Governance. Again, if you see here, so these are your source system, this is your target system, and you are using two components. One is SLT and second is MDG. Okay, SLT to replicate the data, MDG to map the data. And last one, after the data is mapped, the system uses error handling to log the details of any errors encountered. So if there is any error here, let's say, as I gave you the example, there was one call center here which is not mapped in this particular configuration. So what will happen? It will not be able to post. It will go to the error correction. So you have to, your user has to go to the error correction. He has to identify what is wrong, and then he can be able to post it to the universal journal document. So you can choose to make corrections and repost the items or process the item again after, for example, you correct the mapping rules or adjust incorrect values in the document. So either if there is something in error, what you can do is either you rectify the error here itself, or you again transfer that document from here with the right entries. Okay, same thing is explained here. So this is Central Finance. Let's go to the next one. Now, the Central Finance interface, what kind of postings it will bring from here? What are the different things it will bring from here to here? Number one is FI documents. So whatever FI documents will be posted, it will flow from your source system to the target system. CO documents, whatever CO postings you do, they will also go to the Simple Finance or S/4HANA system. And third one is CO cost objects. So whenever a new cost center is created, whenever a new profit center is created, automatically system will try to create a mapping. If not, you have to do the mapping by your own. So there is a possibility that you can set up the replication of cost objects automatically. But if you don't want, if you want to do it manually using this MDG tool, that also can be done. Okay, so for example, if I create a cost center here, if I want the same cost center to be available in S/4HANA finance system, that can be done if I activate this interface for replicating the certain cost objects. So Central Finance can be deployed as on-premise or on cloud. You can see here your Central Finance system, which means this system, it can be, where is that here? So this system can be on-premise or it can be on cloud. So it is completely fine that if you are implementing SAP S/4HANA system on cloud, and then you are sending the data from your local systems to the cloud system. Or it is also possible that you create this Central Finance or S/4HANA finance system on-premise, then too you can send the values from all the systems to on-premise system. So it can be both. It can be on-premise or it can be on cloud. Only difference is, if it is on cloud, data is replicated using the same mechanism. Okay, so there is no change in the mechanism. Only thing is, SLT has to be available on both sending system as well as receiving system. So in this case, this SLT is coming in between, right? So in case of on-premise, let's assume that this is an on-premise setup. In case of on-premise, this SLT has to be installed either into the source systems or into the target systems, not necessarily in both, because both are belonging to the same premise. Okay, so you have the source system also available with you. You have the target system also available with you on the same premise. So you can easily connect to with one single SAP SLT server. But if you are going for cloud, in that case, SLT has to be available on both sending system as well as the receiving system. So this is technical. You don't need to worry about where exactly I need the SLT server, because this will be made available by your basis consultants. And then you have centrally executed processes must not result in back posting to the source system in order to maintain the integrity. This is a very important point. So let me explain what exactly it means. So we are saying whatever data you will be posting here, it will go automatically to this system. But what if I make any manual postings in this system? Will it also go back to this system? No, just remember that. So there is only one way possible. There is only one direction possible. Direction would be only from your local systems to Simple Finance or S/4HANA finance system. Data will never go back from here to here. Okay, same thing is told here. So centrally executed processes must not result in back posting to the source system in order to maintain the integrity. So in order to maintain the integrity, back posting is not allowed. Only foreground posting is allowed from source system to target system. Okay, so at any point of time, if you are able to see some differences between here and here, just go and check here if there is any manual posting done. If the manual posting is done, definitely there will be some differences. Okay, and that is the reason it is not recommended. Normally SAP recommends if you want to perform some adjustment entry at the period end, don't directly do here. Do it here, it will automatically flow here and your both the systems will be reconciled with each other. But if you directly do some postings here, it will definitely not go back to the old system. And definitely in that case, you will find some reconciliation issues. Okay. I think this was our last slide for Central Finance. Yes.
So which one is best?
Which one is based from what, Akash? From three scenarios?
Please open the last slide.
This one?
No.
Three options, you are saying? This one?
No. SLT server screen. Yes. Here you what the month end activity. So we need to do the activity in 4.6 or directly in simple S/4HANA system.
Yes. So you can do month end activity in both. Practically, it is possible to do any posting directly here or here. So when you do it here, automatically through this replication server, it will go to here, right?
So we are correct, no?
Do the postings here and flow it here.
Okay.
Both the ways are correct. If you are not worried about the reconciliation, if you are okay that yes, because I don't want to post here and unnecessarily call the data here, I can directly post it here. But in that case, please be sure that you will not be able to reconcile. So if you are thinking of reconciling, then you have to post it here. If you are completely fine with not reconciling, you know it is not going to reconcile, so let's do the posting here. That is also fine. Okay. One last thing. See, this will happen in real time, starting from when you are activating Simple Finance or when you are activating the Central Finance, right? So for example, in my SAP R3 4.6 system, let's say I am using this system from last 4 years. Okay, and if I activate this scenario now, whatever postings I will do from 2018 onwards, or maybe 19 onwards, based on what is your fiscal year variant, that will go to this system. But the question is, what about the postings which are already available here from last 4 years? So in order to move the values, the historical values from your old system to Central Finance system, there is one time activity which needs to be done when you are implementing this Central Finance solution. What is that one time activity? It is initial load of whatever data is available here for all that 4 years that you have to move to the Central Finance system. So again, before you do this initial transfer, you have to set up the SAP SLT server. You have to do the mappings, master data governance if you are using, or manual mappings using CD tables or something, and then only system will pick this initial load values. Okay, so I'll show you where exactly you can find these configurations related to Central Finance in the system. Okay, so if you go to SPRO, IMG, So within financial accounting, you have this central finance component. Okay, again, this you will not find in SAP ECC. The central finance is, the whole purpose is to migrate the data from older systems to SAP S/4HANA Finance. Okay, so if you go for the central finance, you can see there are source system settings, there are target system settings, and all the settings are technical. Most of the settings are technical except that mappings. Okay, and mappings are done in, normally done in MDG tool. So MDG is also a separate tool. So you can see here, settings for central payment, general replication settings. So let's, again, these are all technical, but I'm just trying to explain you. So here, this is a place where you define from which year you want to start picking the data. So as I told you the example, let me put it here. So our company, okay, let's say we are talking about this company X, company Y, and company Z. They will be posting all of these three companies. So company X, company Y, and company Z. All of this will be now through SLT server will be posting to S/4HANA system, one common system, right? Okay, so this whatever data is going from X, Y, Z to S4, that information you have to specify from which year. So let's say from company X, which means this SAP system, the data will come only from year 2015 because that is when SAP was implemented in company X. For Y, it is, I think, using Oracle system, right? So for Y, let's take the data from 2014, and then let's say company code Z, again it is implemented, let's say, just now, 2018. So this information you have to provide here, like which data you want to load as an initial load first time when you are doing. So here is a place where you are specifying start year from when you want to start. You can post the balances also, and you can also replicate the documents, each and every document if you want. That can also be done using this start document, start year of the documents. You can only go for balances, or you can only also go for documents. It is up to the customer what exactly they want to load in the initial load. Okay, so as I told you, what is your role? Again, I'm explaining, what is your role in the central finance system? Number one, you must be completely aware about the new implementation project in S/4HANA, because the target system, you have to configure everything from scratch. First thing, once your target system is ready, now you will tell, okay, now let's bring the data from the older systems. So in order to bring the data from the older systems, your basis team will implement some SAP nodes on the source system. They will install SAP SLT system and SAP MDG system in between, and you will be responsible for giving the mappings. So you will sit with the customer, you will understand what would be the mapping whenever a data is coming from system X for this company code, which is a corresponding company code in the target target server, for this particular cost center, which is the target cost center, for this particular profit center, what will be the target profit center. So that is our role in the central finance system. I think Vas and Sarah, who is available in our controlling training, they already worked on this central finance system. They both are not here today in this session. They can also add some experience how exactly they have worked on central finance system. Maybe when they are available, I will ask them to just give you some overview of how exactly they have worked, what was their role in that project. So it will be helpful for you. Okay, any questions? Now you understood the difference between central finance and simple finance. These are two completely separate topics. Central finance will be only required in case of landscape transformation, where customer has multiple different systems and they don't want to discontinue that system, and that is the reason they are using both in parallel. So they will use their current system and they will move the data in real time using SLT tool.
So Gaurav, Sandeep here.
Yes, Sandeep.
So how this central finance concept will be merged with the activate methodology?
No, it is, see, activate methodology is the normal methodology of the implementation, even in the landscape transformation. So see, again, as I told you, if you are doing central finance, the first thing is you have to start from the configuration of the new system. You have to make the new system ready. So whenever you are making the new system ready, again, you are following the same activate methodology, right? So you are starting with the prepare, you are exploring, you are conducting the fit gap analysis workshops. Then you are setting up the enterprise structure, which is realization, everything, whatever you have done in new implementation, same thing will apply here also. And then again, from the central finance point of view, again, you have to follow the same steps. So you will prepare. In the prepare, what are the activities? All are the basis activities. You will prepare the SLT tool, you will prepare the MDG tool. Then you have explore. In the explore, you will sit with the customers and understand the mappings. In the realization, you will set up those mappings in the system, and then finally it would be deployed. So activate methodology is common wherever you go, irrespective of whether it is a system conversion project or a new implementation project. The scope and the flow is same. You start preparing, then you explore in the sense you discuss with the customer, get their requirements. Then you have realization where you configure the system, and finally you deploy.
Okay, so these three options, it will be called way of transforming your business from one like ERP to another ERP, or how it will call?
No, the terminologies which we used are the common. So landscape transformations in SAP terminologies, this will be called as landscape transformation replication. You are replicating the data from one system to another system, which can be SAP or non-SAP systems in the source, and in the target it would be always SAP S/4HANA system or simple finance system.
No, Guru, my question is, so like, what will be the question for that? We can give this answer. So there are three ways you can follow. Okay. One is new implementation. So what will be the question, right? Yeah.
Yes. So question can be, maybe the interviewer can directly ask you, do you know what is central finance? Or second thing he can ask you is, let's say I have a customer where they have multiple different systems which they are using for different products or different regions, and now they want to go for S/4HANA. So what you will suggest them, whether they should go for a new implementation or system conversion or landscape transformation? So your answer would be that it totally depends. If a customer is not planning to consolidate, okay, they just want to convert each and every system to S/4HANA, so they can go for system conversion. They can convert each and every system without any consolidation. So whatever number of systems they have today, that much number of S/4HANA systems they will create. But if their plan is to consolidate everything, and again, if they have time, if they are okay to wait for 4 to 5 years, they can start doing the new implementation project where they will migrate all their systems to S/4HANA one by one. But at the same time, if they are not ready to wait, SAP's recommendation is to at least go with the landscape transformation, where you will be using your current systems without any disruption, and you will be loading the values or replicating the values from your current system to SAP S/4HANA system parallelly, where you will be doing your transactions in your same system, and you will be getting the reportings from one common system.
Okay, yeah, Gaurav, thanks.
Okay, so see, there is no straightforward answer. So even let's say tomorrow, if you go to the customer and if they say I have three systems, so you cannot tell him, okay, in that case you should go for landscape transformation, because you have to ask a lot of things. So are you planning to implement that much number of S/4HANA systems, or you are planning for consolidation? If they say consolidation, okay. So if you are going for consolidation, you have a lot of complicated processes. It may take a lot of time to migrate each and every system. So are you okay to wait for 3 4 years? If the customer is saying no, then you can say, okay, SAP has provided one temporary solution where you, till the time we migrate all the systems to S/4HANA, you don't need to wait for the reportings and consolidations. Let's go with this landscape transformation now. And then once all the systems are migrated, we will remove this concept of central finance. So this should be the way how we also are doing with the customers. So there are a lot of projects on central finance you will find in US. In US, there are a lot of projects. Most of the customers, because see, in US, mainly they are having the companies all over the world. There are headquarters in US, and then these companies are present all over the world. And that is the reason they have different SAP systems. So as of now, there are a lot of projects which are happening on central finance there. So as I told you, Vas and Sarov, they both are working in US, and they continuously ask me a lot of things related to central finance, and this is one of the topic that they wanted to understand in detail. Okay. In India, you will not find much of central finance project. Very, very few projects which are in central finance, because normally the headquarters in India and multiple different SAP systems is very rare in India. Okay, so we have a lot of companies where they have hundreds of company codes, but mostly Indian companies try to keep one single system. They don't want to segregate their system. But in US and in Europe, even if you have 10, 15 company codes also, I have seen a lot of such cases where they distribute company codes into multiple different systems. Maybe because they wanted the security that one information of one group should not be available to second group, or whatever is the reason. So they normally use different SAP systems. So if you want to consolidate all of them into one system, it will take a lot of time. But if you have only one system, it is very straightforward. Either you go for new implementation or system conversion. There is no question of central finance or landscape transformation in that case. Okay, Varun, you understood? Akash?
Here goes Sandeep
Yes, Sandeep.
here again. So when we are using central finance concept, right, in our S/4HANA system, so that time when we are preparing or configuring our S/4HANA system, so that time we need to understand, or we need to know the what is the enterprise structure in the existing SAP system or any other non-SAP system, right? So according to that, we need to prepare our system, means enterprise structure also, and other master data structure also, right?
Right. Yes, so that is exactly what you will be doing in the explore phase. In the explore phase, you will understand how many systems are there which you want to consolidate, right? And each and every system, how many company codes do they have? So let's say, for example, if you take this same example, so let's say in company code X, you have 10 company codes, in company code Y, you have 5, and in Z also, you have 5. So most probably, you will be creating 20 company codes here. Right, so that information you will get in the explore phase, like what are the different company codes you want to migrate. Right, Sandeep?
Okay, yes, but as per our activate methodology, which is not similar to the asset methodology, so in activate methodology we will show our SAP system to the customer, so how our SAP work, or like behave and what is the facility we have, right? We don't try to understand the existing system, right? But in this case, I think a little bit concept or the way will be different, right?
Not exactly, because see, before customer decides on S4, they will definitely like to see how S4 HANA system looks like and what are the benefits. So you have to show the demo. Okay, and based on the demo, customers will decide which functionalities, which are the new functionalities which are available in S4 HANA, which they want to utilize here. So simple, if I give you the example, if you don't show them how S4 HANA screens looks like, if you show don't give them demos, how will they know which are the new reporting capabilities available in S4 HANA? Or what are the new transactions to carry out the period end activities if they want to do it here directly instead of doing it in the old system? So definitely you have to follow the same activate methodology where you will be showing them the SAP screens, and based on that they will decide what functionalities they want to activate. Okay, and based on that you will create a document and then you will go for the realization phase. So this fit to standard which you're talking about showing the system, that is called as fit to standard workshops. Fit gap workshops or fit to standard workshops. So they will be there in all the different kind of projects.
Okay, yeah, I got it.
Okay, any questions on central finance? I will share this slides with you today itself. Only thing is I want to change this color. I'm using Apple and I'm not able to change the layout. It could be very easy, but I'm not able to find that. So what I'll do is I'll send this file to my another laptop and I'll change the background and all these things, and then I'll forward you this slides. So these are the same slides that we even discussed in our last to last session. Okay, so please go through the slides. You will be able to recollect a lot of things that we discussed till now. Okay, so now once we are done with central finance, our next topic, if you go through the plan, there are one or two more topics like cash management, and you have this topic of IBP. But what I'm planning is, instead of talking about cash management and IBP now, let's start the migration process. We'll complete the migration and then we will talk about the overview of cash management, IBP and simple logistics, okay, together. So now we will talk about the migration, and migration is nothing but system conversion. So whatever things we have discussed till now, okay, right from the day when we started working on the system. So we created the company codes, we created the enterprise structure, ledgers, fiscal year, chart of account, everything, right? In asset accounting, we created chart of depreciation and all. We have seen COGS, material ledger. So all of these things we started from scratch, right? They were not already configured. We configured everything from scratch. As I told you, there are two kind of projects. Let me again come back to you. Let's forget about landscape transformation now. That has been very clear. So we have a new implementation, and then we have the system conversion. Okay. So when we are saying about new implementation, it means non-SAP or even SAP system, which needs to be discontinued or which needs to be scrapped, and a new S4 HANA system is getting implemented. Right, so new implementation means what? New implementation means we are not going to talk about anything. Either we are not using SAP at all, or even if we are using SAP at all, we are not going to make the use of our existing system. We will scrap our current system and we will continue using, or we will start from scratch. But when it is system conversion, as I told you, we are upgrading. So we are not creating any new third system. We are not creating any new system. We are upgrading the same system, upgrading your current ECC system to S4HANA. Okay, so instead of creating the new system, we are just upgrading that same system to S4HANA. I will give you very simple example. Okay, please try to understand this example. It will make your concepts very clear. Let's say I have a Windows 8 mobile. Okay, in my current, let's say I have a mobile currently and I'm using Windows 8 version. And now Microsoft came up with Windows 10. And I know there are a lot of new functionalities which are available in Windows 10. And I want to use it. I want to go for Windows 10 now. So I have two options. Number one, buy a new mobile. Okay, why I'll buy the new mobile? Let's say, for example, I'm not happy with my current mobile. If I have Windows 8, there is a lot of issues that I'm getting in that mobile and I want to throw it, just wanted to collect whatever data is available into it and I'll move that into the Windows 10 mobile, but I want to start using a completely new mobile. So I'll go for Windows 10, completely new mobile. Although I have a Windows mobile already, I can easily upgrade it. But the thing is, that has become very old. I don't want to use it. I am not happy with it. And I want to start from scratch. I want to go for a completely new mobile. So that is an example of new implementation. Now just consider in SAP, I'm already SAP customer. I'm using SAP from last 5, 10, 15, 20, whatever number of years, right? Now, I know SAP S/4HANA has very, very much new functionalities available and I am ready to use it. And I want to go for SAP S/4HANA implementation. Now the question is, what should I ask myself is, whether I want to upgrade my current system itself or I should purchase a completely new system and start everything from scratch. So if I am starting everything from scratch, then I'm not utilizing my current hardware. I am going for a completely new hardware. So that is a new implementation. Okay. On the other hand, again, coming to my example, instead of buying the new mobile, let's say I will just go to the software update manager and I will just update it to Windows 10. So my same mobile, same hardware is converted to the latest version, right? So that is nothing but system conversion. In case of system conversion, you are using your current hardware as it is and you are upgrading to the latest version. Now let me add one more thing here. Your current hardware will definitely not work on S/4HANA. Okay, so if the question is coming to your mind that if I have a hardware with 8 GB or 16 GB of RAM, I'm just giving you example. Will it work for S/4HANA? Definitely not. Because if you want to implement S/4HANA, you need more RAM, you need more hard disk, and even the hardware need to be certified. Okay, but saying that, I am ready to upgrade my hardware, but I don't want to go for the completely new hardware. I'm upgrading my hardware and then I'm upgrading the software also in the same system. Okay, so in short, instead of configuring, see, if I'm going for new implementation, I have to start from scratch. I have to configure the company code. I have to configure the controlling area. I have to configure the fiscal year variants, everything. But if I'm already having all those things set up in my system, in my ECC system, instead of starting everything from scratch, if I just upgrade it, whatever things are available, they will be also available here. And then I can make those necessary changes which are not available in S/4HANA. So that is a system conversion. System conversion means instead of starting to configure everything from scratch, we are going to use whatever things are available in SAP ECC itself. Okay, even I'm talking about the custom objects. Okay, let's say till now I'm talking about the standard functionalities. What about the custom objects? If I have hundreds of Z reports, if I go for new implementation, all those reports are gone because they were available in your old system. What you need to do, you need to copy those reports and you need to create again in the S/4HANA system. But if I'm upgrading, all those reports are already available in my system. Only thing is I may need some adjustments, because in ECC, whatever reports you're working, maybe they were coming from the tables, which tables are not available anymore in S/4HANA. So I only need to change the reports which is not working in S/4HANA. All other reports which are working, they will also work in S/4HANA. Right, so just understand this as of now, what is the basic difference between implementation and new implementation and system conversion. Any question, any confusion in the difference between new implementation and system conversion now? No confusion? Okay. So now maybe last topic for today is which SAP versions can be converted to S4. Okay, so let me give you the example. Number one, my customer is using SAP 4.7 on Oracle DB. So can this customer use system conversion to convert his system from SAP 4.7 to S/4HANA? What do you think? Can this customer go for system conversion?
I think no.
Okay, you think no. Then what is the answer? Okay, let's say number two. My customer, okay, first of all, you are right. Customer cannot go to SAP S/4HANA from 4.7. Second example is my customer is using SAP ECC EHP 7 on HANA database. So do you think yes, this time he can directly go to S/4HANA?
I think definitely yes, because database and latest version both are sync with S/4HANA.
Right, so you said no, here you said yes. Let's go to the third one. Customer is using SAP ECC EHP 7 again on Oracle DB. What do you think this time? Others also please contribute. What do you think? See, I am not expecting the answer from you. I'm just trying to understand what do you think?
No.
So you are saying no. Akash is saying no. Any other answer here?
As for me, yes, because we need to update first the database. Then we can move to S/4HANA.
Okay, so you are correct. Okay, I'll come back again on this. My customer is using SAP ECC EHP 1 on Oracle DB. So what do you think in this case? This is the last one. So what do you think?
No, from my side.
Okay. Okay. Now let me tell you what is a prerequisite, and then you come again to these questions. So prerequisites for system conversion to S/4HANA. Okay, what are the prerequisites? So for one step conversion, I'll tell you what is one step and what is two step. For one step conversion, the prerequisite is greater than SAP. Instead of greater or equal to, SAP ECC PHP 0. If you are already on SAP ECC EHP 0 or above on any database, then you can go to S4HANA in one single step. Okay. Second option for two-step conversion, any SAP system or any SAP version can be migrated. Okay, now what is the difference between one-step conversion and two-step conversion? So anything greater than or equal to SAP ECC EHP 0 on any database can go to S4HANA. So now again, going through this definition, my customer is using SAP 4.7 on Oracle DB. Now just answer me whether this will be one step or two step. Customer is using 4.7 on Oracle database. So this is one step or two step? Greater than ECC EHP 0. Yes, one step or two step for 4.7?
Two step,
right? Why? Because anything lesser than EHP 0 has to be followed two step. So two step. What do you think about this? Customer is using SAP ECC EHP 7 on HANA database. One step, two step.
One step,
because EHP 7 is greater than EHP 0. Here also EHP 7 is greater than EHP 0. So one step. And here also EHP 1 is also greater than EHP 0. So this is also going to be one step. Okay, what do you mean by one step? In the one step conversion, let me write it here. What is one step and what is two step? So one step means in single step, DB will be converted to HANA and application to S4HANA. Okay, in one step itself, both the activities will be done parallelly. You don't need to perform two separate projects. Okay, it is not necessary to first upgrade the database to HANA and then upgrade the application to S4HANA. No. In one single step, both the activities can be done. What will happen in two step? In two step, step number one would be upgrade system till supported versions. Which are the supported versions? Supported versions for step one. For one step, sorry, not step one, for one step. So if you are using 4.7, first upgrade this 4.7 to at least EHP 0. And once it is on EHP 0, go to the second step. In the second step, you will follow the same thing. DB will be converted to HANA and application to S4HANA. So in short, any system can be converted to S4HANA. Only thing is whether it will be converted in one step or two step. Only systems which are greater than EHP 0 can be converted in one step, irrespective of the database. Okay. And any system which is lesser than EHP 0 will be converted in two step. The first step would be to upgrade to the supported version, and second step would be converting from the supported version to S4HANA. Simple. Just remember this EHP 0 on any database. For one step conversion, greater than or equal to SAP ECC EHP 0 on any database. So next time when you visit the customer, and if a customer is asking you, based on my version, will I need to go for, is it possible first of all to go for system conversion? Yes, you can go to system conversion with, but whether it is first step or second step, it depends upon the version that you are using. So if you are using anything EHP, anything above than EHP 0, then you can go in one step. If you are using anything lesser than EHP 0, you have to follow two steps. Okay. Just remember this. So these are the prerequisites of moving to